The eyes are the windows to the soul. Actually, the mind is the window to the soul. More specifically, memories are your personal windows to the soul. Our brains are so important to how we feel things that they are the organs that make up the feelings. Your brain exists in regards to you, for you, and only you. No one else has your brain. It's like a fingerprint, but even more special and complex. Having a unique brain has its advantages and disadvantages. We thrive in our uniqueness of thought, but also brain problems are more difficult to diagnose due to these issues. It's pretty typical for us to think of older adults when hearing the words memory problems because we are inundated with media and research surrounding the types of dementias affecting the elder population. I stand before you at 23 years old as someone who has memory deficits. But also, at 23 years old, I'm striving to become a graduate student and ultimately a researching professional with a focus in learning, memory, and cognition. I first recognized I had memory problems when I was about 14 years old. As if as a budding teenager, I didn't have enough on my plate already with getting braces for the second time and hormones and changing schools and boys and my period. I realized I had blind spots when I looked to my past. So what can I, a not yet expert, tell you about memory? I do not currently know what type of cognitive deficits I suffer from because memory is looked at as mostly an elderly issue. I've just recently told people about my memory problems, so all the right tests have not been done yet. I kept it a secret because I thought I was dysfunctional since I can't remember things like people around me. Because of this, I've had to teach myself how to learn and remember everything. I would argue that someone with a normal functioning brain has one blind spot, but memory deficits indicate a different story. I not only have one blind spot, but two blind spots. It's like I'm driving on a road to my future with no way to check if I've made the same mistakes before. You don't know how much of your own life you're missing until someone else has to tell you about it. I understand now that we must use photos, trust, and relationships with others to help make information from the blind spot more real and understandable. With the help of photos, stories, and relationships with others around us, I can better understand my life, even if it's something I don't remember. I know I got eye surgery in kindergarten, and my mom got me a cake matching my misfortune. I had a birthday party. Who knew that happened? I didn't. But through photos, connections, and stories, I have a chance to know again. I can relive eighth grade, where I met one of my cousins for the first time, and realize I'm getting older because I just saw him play soccer like an adult. What about graduation photos? High school on the left, Sacramento State this past May on the right. I still have some of my memories from college graduation, but high school graduation 5 years ago, those memories are long gone. I ran track in high school. I know this because of photos and stories. I'm not sure I would know this if I didn't have these tools that have helped me work through my blind spot. What I have also known, with memory deficits or without, is that I have a family and friends behind me that have taken enough pictures and told enough stories to help keep me going. They love me. Even if I look unhappy when I sit between them. The mind is the window to the soul. Memories help us connect with our world and each other. When memories are gone, I must trust others to help me make my blind spot more real. Thank you.